Hey!
What was that about?
She spat in my face. Or might as well have. Called me a whoremonger and a witless hack. Can you imagine? Wit is my forte.
Gotta say, Priscilla's really growing on me.
Save it.
And why don't you save your pouting? Prove to her she's wrong.
Exactly what I plan to do. I've always dreamed of having my own cabaret. A bit of paint and plaster, and this place will do splendidly. Just one hitch. I need coin. So, if you happen to get a break between drowners and ecumajigs, maybe you can help an old friend out.
Get this cabaret idea.
It's been a dream for years. Ever since we went to see one in Oxford. Remember? The dancer hanging from the chandelier? And once she was completely downside up, she called you over and...
I remember.
How could you forget? And this place will be even better, I promise. That is, of course, if I can scrounge together the funds for some remodeling.
How much do you need? Maybe I can lend you the coin.
Thank you, Geralt, but I refuse to take a single crown from you. You know what they say. Fastest way to lose a friend is to loan him some coin. But a favor? That's different.
What kind of favor?
I dated this girl once, Sophronia. That's a name if you can believe it. Has a merchant for a father, importer of spices from Zarakania. And Daddy Dear would never refuse his daughter Dear a thing. We can borrow the coin from her.
Name rings a bell. Isn't this the woman you abandoned without saying a word? Stepped out for a bottle of wine, never to return?
Well, I bought that wine for a reason.
Long time ago, that.
Been away a while, sure. Which is why I need... to draw on your authority. You've got some, you know. No matter what you might think.
Fine. Tell me what you want. Got a feeling you've a plan all cooked up.
Sophronia could still be holding a grudge after our unfortunate parting. But with a touch of help from you, I know she'll forgive me. And then give me that loan.
What's this help entail?
First of all, we need to borrow a dull sword from Madame Irina, one of her props. You know, the kind they use during performances? Get that, then meet me outside Sophronia's house.
Let's say I agree and go see Madame Irina. What will you be doing in the meantime?
Something I have to finish. But I promise I'll do it before you come back with the sword. Then I'll tell you the rest.
Fine, but...
Geralt, the only butts in this plan will be the ones filling my seats. It'll work, you'll see. Get the sword from Madame Irina and meet me outside Sophronia's at sunset.
Oh, my name will never be a gift last time.
What? He never given me nothing but floppy hair.
What's he schemed up this time?
The last individual who tried to come in on my business, it took them a month to find him. Am I being clear, Chive?
What's the fuss about? Can you not treat me as a bit of healthy competition?
Why are you even talking to him, Duke? I've always maintained two smashed knees are worth a thousand words.
Oh, get out! Glad you came.
There a problem?
A problem? There's some kind of problem here, gents. Oh, just wanted you to meet my new pals before they bugger the fuck off. Because we're just parting, right?
We'll have our reckoning yet, Chive. Soon.
What's this? Some flea-ridden mutant got you scared, Duke? Just say the word. I'll take care of him. Take a peek at what he's got inside, then make the midget eat it. Sound good?
Next time, Earl. Let's go.
Right. Don't show your hides round here ever again.
Well, that puts me up to the neck in fucking shite without a shovel.
What's this all about? Doing business with them?
Exactly, they're ploughing opposite. You see, Geralt, old pal.
About to ask me for help, aren't you?
The thing is, I sort of kind of owe a wee sum to a mutual acquaintance, Francis Bedlam, the King of Beggars. To pay off the debt, I've made up my mind to get serious about Gwent.
Getting better by the minute.
Not the playing of it, mind you, but the cards themselves. Rarest of them fetch princely sums these days. Sadly, that's not exactly arcane knowledge. Got a buyer in heat for my collection, missing just 3 cards. But Duke's dregs are all over my arse, so... What do you say, Geralt?
Fine. We'll try to hunt down those cards. Which ones you need?
Fringilla, Vigo, Isengrim, and John Natalis. Devilish hard to get hold of. Duke's been trying too, hasn't had any luck.
Wait, you don't even know where to look for these cards?
Nah, it's not as bad as that. I'm betting Zed's got them. He quit fencing recently, only deals in cards now. Unfortunately, the arsewhite won't talk to me. Not after I bought a one-of-a-kind Scoia'tael card out from under his nose. Would you mind going to see him?
Zed. Sounds familiar.
Big fish in the card pond. There's a shop along the south wall. And thank you, Geralt. I actually think it's time to pay off this debt now.
No problem. See you later, Zoltan.
Well, another free.
I haven't the strength, Geralt. Perhaps you can talk some sense into him.
Help! Save me! I'm dying with poverty.
Where you go with this healer?
Oh, why don't you all get out of here? Get out of here!
As they say,
truth is, we're already dependent on them.
Ah, so good to see you.
Got a request. Need to borrow one of your props. One of the swords you use for stage battles.
My. Whatever do you need that for?
I don't know. But Dandelion claims it's essential.
Oh, yes. I suspected Master Dandelion might have a hand in this. I certainly hope you don't aim to compete with him. Well.
Thanks. I'll try not to damage it. So long.
You're late in the band, so strap me in. Working, man. Come on, twin to me, bang again.
The second sword. Is it in case the first one breaks?
Hey. Did you see those poor wretches who fell belly?
So the worst scum flows into Novigrad. Sorceresses.
Thank you.
finally made it. Listen, here's the plan. Sophronia loves adventure-filled romance novels. I can be a hero in her eyes if I can just save her from a bandit. I'll have her eating out of my hand, and there's no way she'll begrudge me that loan.
Want me to be the bandit?
Knew you'd see the sense in it right away.
This could actually work.
Written your lines already.
You've written what?
So you know what to say during the performance. Here, Andromask, put it on. Sophronia can't recognize you.
But...
No time. Sophronia's coming. Stick to the plan. We'll meet at the Rosemary in the morning.
Stop right there.
What is this? Help! Save me!
Tremble, flaxen-haired wench. Bow before the Prince of Thieves.
Not so fast. Drop your sword, scoundrel. This is your first and last warning.
Dandelion!
Tis I, though the scum of the city call me the Crimson Avenger.
No, not the Crimson Avenger.
Silence, vermin! You shall regret the day you were born.
You're better than I thought.
Go on, Dandelion. I mean, Crimson Avenger.
The Crimson Avenger triumphs again.
My hair. Are you well?
One blow struck true. Another scar from my collection.
Come inside. I shall bandage you up. Be gone, vile bandit, or the Crimson Avenger will beat you senseless!
You're here too early.
We agreed to meet today, so we've come today. Supplies are all hauled in and the crew's raring to work. We'll start just as soon as our lovely directress gets round to deciding on the decoration.
But Dandelion doesn't even have the coin to pay you.
Turns out he does now, or soon will. At any rate, he's working on it.
See? It's all peachy. So will you finally decide what style you want for this interior?
What are our choices?
Master Dandelion said he was torn between boudoir style and theater decor. Promised to let us know his choice as soon as we arrived. Now we're here, but no decision's been made. And the lady's horribly surprised she's to choose. Apparently, this whole renovation's for her sake.
For me?
Well, it's not for me. Now, would you please decide where I bust a vessel?
I've no idea what Dandelion would like. Geralt, you've known him longer. Say something.
Sure, I've known him longer. Never so much as changed his socks for me. Never mind commissioning a full-blown renovation. He's He's doing this for you, clearly. You should decide.
I associate boudoirs with a feminine elegance that also has an edge. Claws, you might say. That fits a cabaret perfectly.
A wonderful choice it is. At last. Gentlemen, you're done lollygagging. Get to work.
Well, well. Guess this cabaret's the real thing.
Ever since Dandelion inherited this place, he's talked about it constantly. I just never expected him to take action. And so quickly.
Who knows? Might even settle down now. I'll have to keep an eye on the business. Who would have known?
Despite what people say about him, Dandelion approaches life very rationally.
True enough. Adheres to the principle that a life enjoyed is a life well lived.
You needn't mock.
I'm not. I mean that. Nothing wrong with the principle. Dandelion just knows how to enjoy life. It's a good thing.
Dandelion can also be responsible. He always pays anyone who works for a long time, and he's never missed a performance.
Sure hope your opening won't be the first. He's still not here.
Well, he said as soon as he got the coin, he'd go see Polly, our choreographer. She's missed the last few rehearsals. I certainly hope he's not gotten into trouble.
Anything's possible with Dandelion. Let me see if I can't find him.
All we need is a mutant.
And her half-brained fiancé. They're fighting. She's the only one in this town who knows anything about choreography, and that lummox won't let her work for me. Hold on. What are you doing here? We were going to meet at the Rosemary.
We were, but you didn't show. Priscilla started to worry, so I came to see how you were doing.
Priscilla started worrying about me? That's so nice.
Less for her than for you, I'm sure. So let's get back.
Did you not hear what's going on in there? We've got to help Polly. Why do beautiful women always end up with such dicks?
No idea. Stand back. I'll break the door down.
Wait! Do we have to destroy her house? She keeps a spare key around here somewhere.
How would you know she keeps a spare key around here?
It's not as if we started working together yesterday. Before Polly joined forces with Hubio...
You'd visit her? Often?
I'd hide out here while Priscilla and Polly rehearsed at the Rosemary in Time. They worked on the dance numbers I composed.
So, Polly's not one of your...
I never mix business and pleasure.
The one exception being Priscilla.
Who you were just saying is worried about us. So enough of the chatter, and start looking.
Fine. Let's find the key.
Find anything?
Not here.
This. Get out of my ass!
Watch it, and leave the woman alone.
What the... She's my betrothed!
But I'm not your property!
I love her! I'll not let her sway her ass in his brothel!
Whoa, slow down there a minute. This is clearly one gigantic misunderstanding. One I can clear up in the blink of an eye.
Shove your excuses up your ass!
Sod off, or I'll split your skull.
My friend asked you nicely, so please be courteous in return and hear him out, or we'll settle this another way.
All right, talk.
Hubio, right? Polly's told me so much about you. She said you're erudite and have an open mind.
You said that? Well, there's a truth to it. My mind's the open salt, but its open saltiness ends when my betrothed starts wagging her arse around brothels. Get out of here, both of yous. Polly's not going anywhere.
Let him finish. There's no brothel involved.
You see, friend, Geralt just hit the nail on the head. For what you have there is the old publicity placard.
Old?
Very. From a time when my establishment was under different management. I, however, would never let any indecency take place in my cabaret. My very reputation precludes it.
So, what's all this about?
Your betrothed is a first-class artiste, and I want to offer her a position worthy of her talents. She's to be my choreographer, and that in turn means she'll receive a share of the proceeds from every performance she choreographs.
You mean to say coin?
And fame. No flirting required. You have my word.
Suppose... in that case...
I knew you'd agree.
It's settled then. See you at the Rosemary, Polly.
Well, I'm off.
I'll catch up to you. Whew. Never expected that to go so well.
You handled it well, Dandelion. Man was bodying your hands once you called him erudite.
In negotiation, as in combat, the key is to find your opponent's weak spot and exploit it to the hilt.
So, time to head back?
I've still got to stop by Rotlix. Commissioned some new placards from him a while ago, but Hubio came across the old version. Plowing artists got some serious explaining to do.
I'll go see Rotlix. You head back to the Rosemary. Priscilla will have my head.
Really? You'd go?
No, said that for the hell of it. Tell me where he lives.
Portside.
See you soon.
Poor man's always got it uphill.
Looking for Rotlix.
You ain't alone. Damn halfling's in debt to half the city, but I'm here to scrape mine before the carcass is picked clean.
There's not enough for everyone, so bugger off. Feeding time's first come, first served.
Take what you want. I'm just here for some placards.
You deaf. Didn't you hear me? This is all mine now. Fuck off, freak.
And here I thought we'd resolve this peacefully.
You'll regret this, mutant. Tell me what you want. Damn it!
placards.
There ain't no ploughing placards here.
And Rodlick, where's he?
Same place as always. Vagal Bud Estate, losing his last crowns at the races.
See, wasn't that easy. Could have said so right away. Take it easy. Giddy up.
Considerable sum in the red.
You, Rodlick?
Henri Rodlick? Artist, painter, debtor, and martyr to my art. At your service.
Dandelion sent me.
Oh, yes. Tell him his placards are done and safely hidden away. Yet, alas, I cannot fetch them, as a group of angry creditors has seized my home.
Think I might have run into one of them.
Then you know my predicament. Now, Count de Louverton has offered me the chance to win it all back. I'm to wager on a race.
Generous. Not just anybody could afford to do that.
De Louverton is not just anybody. He's Duke Sam's youngest son. Sam of the well-known family of gem dealers. One debt more or less makes little difference to him.
What's there to worry about? This is your chance to settle up, get a clean slate.
We've had a spell of bad luck lately. Should I agree to de Louverton's offer and lose, I shall be in bondage to him for all time.
Let me pay off your debt. No strings attached.
Thank you. I never expected this. May I ask to what I owe this generosity?
Let's just say I like to do a good deed from time to time. Can we get those placards now?
I'll bring them to the Rosemary in time, just as soon as I settle my obligations.
Fine. See you there.
FMG Major, and...
I told...
Well, well. See, the crew's been hard at work. Not bad.
No. No, not all. But I'd imagine something more... You know, more theatrical.
Don't you like it? But I thought a boudoir would be right in line with your tastes.
Oh, you chose it. Well, I'm not saying it's bad. Just different. Not exactly what I'd envisaged. You know, now that I think about it, you're absolutely right. A boudoir's the perfect setting for a cabaret. What about Rotlick? Did you get the placards?
Rotlick said he'd bring them on his own. Should be here soon.
Great! The best way I can think of to promote the chameleon.
Never mentioned wanting to change the name.
Rosemary and Thyme wasn't all bad. But it conjured images of Temerian cuisine served by waitresses in peasant garb. Chameleon's a lot better for a cabaret, apart from which it emphasizes that the place has undergone a transformation. Just a better ring to it all round.
What about choreography? Prepared anything special for the opening?
We haven't. But Polly has. She's priceless. Came in and brought the girls in line before I could say knickers. Premier will have the audience on their feet, on their knees, both at the same time.
Guess everything's ready. So when's the opening?
Soon. We start our dress rehearsal in an hour. I just need to nip back home for my dress.
Thanks for everything.
Don't mention it.
Seems my cabaret dreams are about to come true. So, around to celebrate? I'm buying.
Why not?
That's my boy. The foreman mentioned he saw you and Priscilla talking.
He saw right.
And she say anything about me?
Can't say I remember. Why do you ask?
No reason.
Well, well. Never thought I'd live to see the day. Dandelion living in monogamy.
I've always been monogamous. Well, near enough. I just changed muses often.
Priscilla, another one for your collection?
No, she's its crowning glory.
One thing's eating me. How do you manage to get the loan from Sophronia?
Ugh, wasn't easy. She got so excited about our performance, I had to read to her for 4 hours. 4 hours from the cloak and the dagger.
You mean you didn't?
Are you crazy? Who do you think I am?